Hello, everybody. My name is Kyung. I'm tax partner of the Yulchon LLC, a Korean law firm. And also, I'm a professor of the University of Seoul in Korea. I'm very glad to have an opportunity to present to you the main idea, main parts of the OECD transfer pricing guidelines, which is one of the most important concepts in international tax area these days. I will cover largely the OECD basic principles of transfer pricing guidelines, and I also cover the technical parts of the UN practical manual on transfer pricing. So in this session, I will cover the concept of the transfer price, and then I will introduce you the most important concept of the transfer pricing, that is Amgen's principle. And then I will slightly touch upon the global formulary apportionment method, which is actually contradictory to the Amgen's principle. So as a consequence, rejected by the OECD. And then in this slide, I'd like to introduce the concept of the transfer price, why that becomes important all over the world. Rapid development in technology and transportation and communication have brought about multinational enterprise in the world. If I mention the characteristics of the multinational enterprises, I can say that they have generally the flexibility in placing their places all over the world. And the structures of the transactions of the multinational enterprise group is largely determined by group-driven forces rather than the open market conditions between independent entities. In such a situation, it becomes important to establish the appropriate price called transfer price, especially because even the multinational enterprises need some tool for measuring the right performance of each individual entities in their group. So in order to properly measure the performance of the entity in their group, they need some mechanism that is, which is often called as transfer price. That is actually the original reason why the concept of the transfer price comes out. Transfer pricing is the general term for the pricing of the cross-border intra-firm transactions between related parties. Transfer pricing, therefore, refers to the setting of the prices for transaction between associated enterprises involving the transfer of the property or services. These transactions are also referred to as controlled transaction, as distinct to the uncontrolled transactions between companies that are not associated. Therefore, the transfer pricing does not necessarily involve tax avoidance in the perspective of a taxpayer, but in the perspective of the countries concerned, there is actually the transfer pricing issues have the potential to shift their profits between countries. Examples in this slide shows how the multinational enterprise shifted their profits into other countries using transfer pricing mechanism. the company X and company Y are associated enterprises of XY group. Company X actually produces a watch in country A and sells. They export it to country B. In other words, the company, the associated enterprise of company Y, and then that company Y resell the products to the consumers in located in country B. In the process of selling the product, they spend 100 as a distribution cost. So, as you can see in this table, the sales amount could be 1,400 or 1,000. We assume that there are two options of transfer prices for this XY group. If they choose 1,400 as a transfer price, then the sales amount would be 1,400. The cost would be 500 because you assume that the manufacturing cost is 500 here. And then the income would be 900. If you assume the tax rate in the country A is 30%, and we assume the tax rate in country B is 40%, you can find that the tax amount in company X would be 2,270, and the profits of the after-tax would be 630. In total, the XY group, they earn 630 as a profits after tax. What happened if they change the transfer price from 1,400 to 1,000? Then you can find that their profits after tax reduce to 590. That is because they have to pay more tax in country B, 160, even though they can save 120 of taxes in country A. So, as a consequence, they have to reduce the profits after tax by changing the transfer price from 1,400 to 1,000. So, I can see you can you can find my point here. The multinational enterprise can shift the profits, their profits, from A countries to another countries by changing their transfer price. Even though the main purpose is to get the most of the, even though they can have the largest profit by changing the transfer price, but it gives a consequence that they actually end up shifting the profits to other countries. That is the concern of the countries involved. Now, so in that perspective, I'd like to talk about the basic issues of underlying transfer pricing. Transfer pricing serves to determine the income of both transfer price involved in cross-border transaction. This transfer price influences the tax base of countries involved. The key jurisdiction issues here, as you can find in this blackboard, which government should tax the income of the group entities engaged in the transaction? What happens if both governments claim the right to the same income? If the tax base arises in more than one country, should one of the governments give tax relief to prevent double taxation of the relevant entity's income? And if so, which one? That is the issues that the tax authorities have to consider. Now, I'd like to move on to the next slide. This slide actually addressing the issues which was covered by the previous example. I'd like to draw your attention to this transfer price. As you can remember already, the XY group set up their transfer price as 1400, but it gives the result that the company Y shows no profit as a consequence. So the company when the company Y is audited by country B tax authority, tax authority considered that transfer price, so there must be something wrong in the transfer price. So they actually set up this price. They changed this price to 1300 so that the company Y gets the 100 of profits, which is subject to tax in country B. Company X has already paid taxes to country A under the premise that the transfer price would be 1400. However, because the country B changed the transfer price from 1400 to 1300, this company, company X and company Y, in other words, the XY group, has to suffer the double taxation because of the country B's tax assessment. So from this slide, I'd like to emphasize that if a one country adjusts the tax base, the transfer pricing base of one country, but the other country does not provide so-called corresponding adjustment in response to that taxes in the other country, the multinational enterprises should suffer the double taxation. That is the key issue I'd like to address in this slide. Now I'd like to talk about the arm's length principle. This is, as I mentioned already, this arm's length principle is the overarching concept in the whole transfer pricing exercise. As I mentioned already, this concept is needed by multinational enterprise because they need to measure the performance of the individual entities in their group. However, the purchasing entity, if the purchasing entity belong to the M&E group, even though they have transaction between related parties, if they need to show their activities, their performance, they would only acquire products if purchase price equal to or cheaper than prices being charged by unrelated suppliers. Otherwise, they would not make a transaction with such related parties. The same reasoning applied to the selling entity. They would also only sell products if the sales price is equal to or higher than prices being charged by unrelated purchasers. So you can understand that even though the price is negotiated between related parties, between associated enterprises, prices should, on this basis, gravitate toward arm's length price. So when transfer pricing does not arm's length price, then tax liability of the multinational enterprise and tax revenue of the host country could be distorted. Now, in this slide, I'd like to talk about more elaborate the concept of the Amgen's principle. The underlying idea behind Amgen's principle is to place transactions both uncontrolled and controlled on equal terms with respect to tax advantages or disadvantages they create. Under Amgen's principle, intergroup transactions are tested and may be adjusted if transfer prices are found to deviate from comparable arm's length transactions. Arm's length principle should be accepted as it uses the marketplace as the norm. Arm's length price is accepted guiding principle in establishing transfer price on the Article 9 of both OECD and UN Model Tax Convention. Most countries, including OECD countries, have agreed that for the tax purposes, the profits of M&E may be adjusted as necessary to correct tax distortions. Appropriate adjustment is achieved by establishing the conditions of the commercial and financial relations that they would expect to find between independent enterprises. Paragraph 1 of the Article 9 of the OECD Model Tax Convention says, where conditions are made or imposed between two associated enterprises in their commercial or financial relations, which differ from those which would be made between independent enterprises, then any profits which would but for those conditions have accrued to one of the enterprises, but by reason of that conditions have not so accrued, may be included in the profits of that enterprise and taxed accordingly. This part is the conclusive part, the included in the profits of the enterprise and taxed accordingly. That is the authoritative description which is included in the OECD and UN Model Tax Convention regarding transfer pricing. Arm's length principle follows the approach of treating the members of the M&E group as operating as separate entities. So, naturally, this separate entity approach treats the associated enterprise as if they were independent entities. The focus is naturally placed on whether condition of associated enterprises differ from then would be obtained in comparable uncontrolled transactions. So I'd like to draw your attention to this point. The conditions of associated enterprises and conditions of the uncontrolled transaction, you need to compare these two elements, conditions or situation of the associated enterprise and conditions and situation or terms of the uncontrolled transaction. That is actually the basic concept of the comparability analysis, which will be dealt with in an in-depth manner in my later lecture. Now I'd like to introduce some criticism over arm's length principle. Some of the tax experts argue that arm's length principle may not always account for economies of scale and interrelations of diverse activity of integrated business. So they argue that the arm's length principle is not necessarily should not be necessarily the governing principle among control transactions. Then another issue they raise is that associated enterprises may engage in transaction that independent enterprises would not undertake. Third issue they raise is that arm's length principle may result in administrative burden for both taxpayer and tax administration, because they have to be involved in so-called comparability analysis, but it is not easy game, actually. It requires a lot of efforts and time or money sometimes to conduct the comparability analysis in a proper way. Finally, both tax administration and taxpayers often have difficulties in obtaining adequate information to apply arm's length principle. That is the main criticism over arm's length principle. However, OECD maintains the arm's length principle as international consensus because, in theory, the arm's length principle is quite sound, providing the closest approximation of the workings of open market. If they move away from the arm's length principle, they would have difficulties in resolving the double taxation issue. They may end up finding the position that there would be no solution about double taxation if we just rely on some other mechanism. Actually, the opponents of the arm's length principle addresses and proposed another approach, so-called global formulary apportionment approach. Then I will introduce the main concept of this approach. This approach is to indicate the approach which allocates the global profits of the M&E group on a consolidated basis among the associated enterprises in different countries on the basis of predetermined formula. Global formulary apportionment is different from profit split methods, which will be introduced later in my lecture. Global formulary apportionment means it indicates a kind of use of formula through the predetermined way for all taxpayers to allocate profits. Whereas the profit split methods, it indicates to compare on a case-by-case basis. I'd like to stress this underlying point. Case-by-cases, the profits of one or more associated enterprises. So even though the profit split method uses some formula, it is not general formula. It is used only case by case for a specific situation. Also, I'd like to mention the difference between global formulary apportionment and the selected application of formula developed by both tax administration. The latter, in other words, the formula developed by tax administration is often developed in the course of mutual agreement procedures or APA, which means the advanced pricing arrangement between transfer pricing authorities. That process is actually done in cooperation with specific taxpayer or multinational enterprise group, after careful analysis of the particular facts and circumstances. So my point is here that general formula apportionment is a kind of formula applies all over the world without any exception, basically. However, the other concepts, profit split method, or a formula developed by tax authorities in the course of some negotiation between them, is a kind of formula only using in the specific cases. So that's the main difference of between the two. Global formula apportionment has been promoted as an alternative to the arm's length principle, as I mentioned already. However, it is actually rejected by OECD. That is because, as I mentioned already, the global formula apportionment has many problems. Here, I'd like to highlight some main parts of the problem of the global formula apportionment. First of all, the measurement of the global tax base of multinational group is extremely difficult. The use of the common accounting system they need, and they also have to use the factors which is generally agreed by tax authorities in different jurisdictions. They also have to develop the right measure to weigh the factors influencing the taxable amount of the each entity of the multinational group. So if tax authorities or taxpayers agreed to those concepts, they need a lot of time and efforts to reach an agreement. So in other words, it's that this exercise is very time consuming and extremely difficult to accomplish. So actually, as I mentioned already, OECD rejected the global formula apportionment and reiterated their support for the use of arm's length principle. In this first session, I try to deliver the main concept of the transfer pricing, including arm's length principle and global formula apportionment. I hope my first session was very useful for your understanding on transfer pricing. In the next session, I will also cover another very important issue in transfer pricing, that is comparability analysis. I hope that you can enjoy my lecture and have better understanding on transfer pricing. Thank you very much. See you next time.